Can you not? I just see YOLO. Okay. If I could spell.
Shows her back. She looks so good.
Yeah. any keys?
No.
I got them. You sure you're okay?
Okay, I'll be sending a rescue and I'll be sending squads for traffic control. If you hear of any injuries, just give us a call back.
Okay, I will.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
pulse is 110, respirations 20.
Hi, I'm the ER doctor here. We're gonna take care of you. Airway's clear, guys. Okay, we're gonna check you out, okay? We're gonna make sure everything's okay. I'm gonna start taking this off, but I don't want you to move your head, okay? Alright, do you know where you are? Do you know what year it is? Alright, what do you remember? Alright, what's the last thing you remember? Do you remember hitting your head?
No.
You remember if you passed out? Alright, let's get her off the board. Let's roll it.
Got it. 2, 3.
Alright, we're just gonna go through everything here, okay? Alright, take some nice big deep breaths. And again. Heart, lungs, clear. ER doctor here. Are you with Manny's parents?
Yes.
Alright, so a couple of things. She was in a car accident and she seems to remember it, but she has a bad cut over here. Examining her, she wasn't able to move her legs. We sent her over for a CAT scan real quick. So it looks like she's broken part of her spine, fractured her vertebrae, causing compression of her spine, which is why she's not able to move her legs. So right now she's paralyzed from the waist down. Okay. But we're going to have some neurosurgeons come take a look at her and see what all our options are to get her walking again. Okay?
I don't think he's conscious right now. We have him on the monitor. He's still doesn't have a pulse for now, though. He said we're going to go to room 1. Part of the windshield in his right forehead. He also has a lack on his neck. Bleeding is controlled at this time by a horse collar. The patient initially was able to talk to us. And he
have a pulse.
I don't hear anything. Start CPR.
We need help in here. Call the code.
Start anything.
Give me an intubation setup.
We need the intubation cart.
Alright, he's in VTAC. Alright, let's get ready to shock him.
Stand clear.
Stand clear.
Everyone clear?
Oxygen off?
Okay, clear. Clear.
Shock delivery.
Hi. No pulse.
No one feels anything?
Should cast one.
Alright. We've had 3 shocks. He's not responding to medications. There's nothing more we can do here. Time of death? 8:35.
Hello. This way. Keep going. Keep going. It's just looking for a deep long sample, so keep going.
Nicholas Dalton, you're here for sentencing on two accounts of homicide by intoxicated use of a vehicle and a third account of causing great bodily harm by the intoxicated use of a vehicle. Because of your actions, Joshua Berwald and Matthew Bevis are dead, and Madeline Hottinger will never walk again. I don't know you. I don't know how well you knew Matthew, Joshua, or Madeline. I don't know them well enough to think about what they might have been thinking when they were drawing their last breaths. When Joshua and Matthew were lying there dead, were they thinking about school? Were they thinking about their mom and dad? Were they thinking about siblings? Were they thinking about their future? Because of you, we'll never know. Because of you, they're dead. And I know that you didn't set out on the morning of May 15th, 2014 to kill someone. But you did. You have destroyed the lives of Matthew and Joshua and permanently damaged the lives of Madeline and altered all three of the family's lives. Your actions don't just affect you, they don't just affect your family. They affect the families of the victims. I hope you understand that. Because of the damage you have done, because of the things you have taken, you must pay a consequence. That consequence is 25 years in prison.
Something to remember.